Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Ra'd, chapter number 13, verse number 38, that we have sent a revelation in every age. That means there was several revelations sent on the face of the earth. But by name, only four revelations of Almighty God are mentioned in the Quran. The Torah, the Zabur, the Injil, and the Quran. The Torah is the Wahi, the revelation which was given to Moses, peace be upon him. Zabur is the Wahi, the revelation which was given to David, peace be upon him. Injil is the Wahi, the revelation which was given to Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. And Quran is the last and final revelation which was given to the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. But all the revelations that came before the last and final revelation, the glorious Quran, they were only sent for one particular group of people. They were only sent for one nation. And the message which was mentioned in these scriptures was meant to be followed only till a particular time period. But the last and final revelation, the glorious Quran, it was not sent only for the Muslims or only for the Arabs, as the Quran says in Surah Ibrahim, chapter number 14, verse number 1. Alif Lam Ra. We have revealed the book to thee, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, so that thou may leadest the humankind from darkness to light. Allah says in Surah Ibrahim, chapter number 14, verse number 52, that here is a message for humankind. Let them take warning therefrom. Let them know there is only one God. Let the men of understanding take heed. Allah says in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 185, Ramadan was the month in which the Quran was revealed as a guidance to humankind, as a criteria to judge right from wrong. Allah says in Surah Az-Zumur, chapter 39, verse number 41, that we have revealed the book to thee, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, to instruct the humankind. It does not say to instruct only the Muslims, only the Arabs. It says to instruct the whole of humankind. Thus we know that all the three great prophets, all the three great personalities, Moses, Jesus, and Muhammad, peace be upon them all, they preached one common message of submission to the will of one true God. All of them, they preached Islam. Islam comes from the root word silm or salam, which means peace. It also means submitting your will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Almighty God. And any person who submits his will to God, in Arabic, it's called as a Muslim. And if we read and if we analyze the scriptures of all these three great personalities, they had one common message of submission to the will of God. And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 1, in the book of Iman, hadith number 7, the Prophet said that the religion of Islam is based on 5 principles, on 5 pillars. And the Prophet said, the first is the Shahada, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, that there is no God but Allah, and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the messenger of Allah. And Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 177, it is not righteousness that you turn your face to the east or west, but it is righteousness that you believe in Allah, that you believe in the last day, that you believe in his angels, that you believe in his books, and you believe in his messengers. It is compulsory that anyone who submits his will to Almighty God, he should believe in one God, he should believe in the last day, in the hereafter, he should believe in the angels of Almighty God. He should believe in all the books, all the revelations of Almighty God. And he should believe in all the messengers, all the prophets of Almighty God. I started my talk by quoting a verse from the glorious Quran, from Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 64, which says, Kul ya ahlal kitab, Say, O people of the book, say to the Jews and Christians, Talaw ila kalmitin sawa im bainan o bainakum. Come to common terms asked between us and you. Which is the first term? Allah na'budu illallah. That we worship none but Allah. Wala nushrika bihi shayyan. That we associate no partners with him. Wala yattakhiza ba'dun ba'dan arbaban min dunillah. That we erect not among ourselves lords and patrons other than Allah. Fa'intawallaw. If then they turn back. Fakulu shadu. Say ye bear witness, bianna muslimoon, that we are Muslims bowing our will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The best way to speak with different types of people, Allah says, ta'ala wila kalmitin sawa'im bainana bainakum. Come to common terms as between us and you. Which is the first term? Allah na'budu illallah. That we worship none but one Almighty God. And this is the message that was preached by all the messengers, all the prophets of Almighty God. And the best definition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that can be given from the Quran is Surah Ikhlas, chapter number 112, verse number 1 to 4, which says, Kul huwa Allahu ahad. Say, He is Allah one and only. Allahu samad. Allah the absolute and eternal. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He begets not, nor is he begotten. Walam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. There's nothing like him. This is a four-line definition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of Almighty God, which is given in the glorious Quran. If any person says so and so candidate is God, if that candidate fits in this four-line definition, the Muslims have got no objection in accepting that candidate as God. The first is Kul huwa Allahu ahad. Say he is Allah one only. Second, Allahu samad. Allah the absolute and eternal. Third, Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He begets not, nor is he begotten. Wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. There is nothing like him. Surah Ikhlas is the touchstone of theology. It is the litmus test to confirm whether the candidate is Almighty God or not. And the same message was preached even by Prophet Moses, peace be upon him. It's mentioned in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 6, verse number 4. Moses, peace be upon him, said, Shema Israelo, Adna Lahainu Abna Ikhad. It's a Hebrew quotation which means, Yoro Israel, the Lord, our God, is one Lord. And when Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was asked, that which is the first of the commandments, he repeated verbatim what was said earlier by Moses, peace be upon him. And it's mentioned in the Gospel of Mark, chapter number 12, verse number 29. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, Shema Israelo, Adna Lahainu Abna Ikhad. It's a Hebrew quotation which means, Yoro Israel, the Lord, our God, is one Lord. And all the messengers of Almighty God, they preached that you should not associate partners, any partners, with this one true God. And it's mentioned in the Quran, in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4. Verse number 116. And Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 48, it says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never forgive the sin of associating partners with him. Any other sin, if he pleases, he may forgive. But if anyone who has associated partners with Almighty God, he has strayed away very far. The biggest sin in any religion is associating partners with Almighty God. And the same message was given by Moses, peace be upon him. It's mentioned in the book of Exodus, chapter number 20, verse number 3 to 5, it says, Almighty God says, that thou shalt have no other God besides me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image of anything, of any likeness in the heaven above, in the earth beneath, and the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down to them, nor serve them, for I, thy God, thy Lord, is a jealous God. And the same message is further repeated in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 5, verse number 79, where it says, that thou shalt have none other God besides me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image of anything, of any likeness in the heaven above, in the earth beneath, and in the water beneath the earth. Thou shalt not bow down to them, nor serve them, for I, thy God, thy Lord, is a jealous God. So if you read the message of these three great men, you'll get the message that they preached that you should worship only one God and you should not associate any partners with him. But unfortunately, yet there are some of the followers of these great men to attribute partners to Almighty God. There are many Christians who claim that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he claimed divinity. In fact, the Quran says in Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 72, it says, لَقَدْ قَفْرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهُ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمَ. They are doing kufr. They are blaspheming those who say that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is Almighty God. وَقَالَ الْمَسِيحُ. But said Christ, يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ, O children of Israel, أَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ, worship Allah, رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ, who's my Lord and your Lord. Inna mushrik billah, anyone who associates partners with Allah, faqad harram Allah alayhi al-jannah, Allah will make jannat haram for him. Paradise will be forbidden for him. Wama bahun nar, wama lizzalimin min ansar, and fire shall be his dwelling place, and he shall have no helpers in the hereafter. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, Inna mushrik billah, anyone who associates partners with Allah, faqad harram Allah alayhi al-jannah, Allah